I'm Christian Ortiz.
I'm Rubén Banegas.
We're the writers and directors of Two Bosses. Two Bosses is a film that my brother and I started and created right here in our apartment. Being a musician and photographer for years, I already had all the equipment needed. Once we realized we were going to be quarantined for a while, I decided it was time to make a movie. I needed a cast, I know I wanted a cast from all over the world, and I needed to get started on a script immediately. I joined a ton of indie film groups on social media, and I started my search. Thanks to COVID and strict social distancing, though, I was able to film my actors on FaceTime. Yeah, it was definitely a last-minute project.
Very cool project.
When I found out we had to be isolated for so long, I was like, oh shit, man, this is gonna be bad. We're hyper-creative, so we do whatever we can to come up with stories, photography, music, art, whatever. We're creators at the end of it all.
By the way, check out Mod Atlas. A lot of the ideas that are just boom, bam, right at the moment.
I'll do like the rappers do. Mod Atlas Media, baby. This is the right mask, right? Okay, cool.
Not my mask, but Mod Atlas Media, baby, right there.
Action.
I love you, boy. I'm proud of you, see? You're a tough kid. You're gonna make through it, man. It's gonna be all right.
Now I play Reynaldo Rocky Reyes. My character is a lot of complicated. Rocky, like I am in real life, is diabetic. And because of that, I'm at high risk of catching the COVID-19. Rocky goes from zero to fuck damn in 0.0006 seconds.
My brother and I are close in real life, and I wanted the film to capture that. Rocky is beyond protective over Charlie, and Charlie, as aggravated as he may seem, loves his brother.
Nah, he ain't got a choice.
Although Rocky is the high-risk one, Charlie is the one COVID hits the hardest. Charlie and I play billionaires who manage 8 global businesses. While Charlie enjoys the guns, Rocky is a little different.
Yeah, Rocky goes the other way. Rocky uses knives, loves knives. The way he sees it is that he likes to get up close and personal with these cats, so he uses knives to cut them wide open.
Charlie and Rocky are two latchkey kids from the Bronx. I wanted to tell a story of the American dream as many poor kids imagine it to be. Although they are heads of the largest brokerage firms in the country, the film shows that no matter what kind of legitimate business you want your corporation to be, sometimes you deal with some real shady characters. Sometimes, in order to get legitimate, you have to do it in illegitimate ways. They divided their businesses between coasts. Charlie owning Riker Inc., Louis Market and Metrics, now known as Lou Metrics Merger, Tridart Industries, and New Site Aya Uganda. Rocky manages New Site Australia, Riker New York, Tomi Hofu Bounty Investments in Japan, and the Metro Boutique in downtown New York.
See? That thing?
They recruit their baby brother as the cleaner, the one who handles dirty jobs.
It's done.
David McKenzie is appointed underboss of the East Coast.
Go to sleep. You really do look like shit.
While Christy Davies is appointed underboss of the West.
Charlie, we had a problem, but I fixed it.
Hey, I'm so sorry.
Rosie Reyes, Charlie's wife, is quarantined in New York with the kids. Daniel Wheezy Woods, played by Derek Nason, is the Reyes brothers' main runner, responsible for knowing absolutely everything and handling all types of business when needed. Abubakar Abbas was recruited to play Musazi, Charlie's most trusted foreign aide. Tristan Hankins plays Hunter Maxwell, a troubled teen who's Rocky's runner. Hunter's dad, Troy, played by Kevin Hankins, has a lot to say about it.
Yeah, just shut your mouth and pay attention. You need to leave my son alone.
Charlie Reyes.
Remember those shady characters I mentioned earlier? Meet Gloria Bianco, played by Kelly King.
Wait, wait. Before you continue to insult my intelligence, you need to ask yourself a series of important questions. Questions like, does a woman who comes home to her slain husband deliver the wrath of the gods to her enemies? Or does the man who took her husband's life suffer the same fate?
With a soundtrack fueled by indie artists from all over the world, to actors from all over the world, I wanted to create a project that would open doors for people who wanted to do something bigger than themselves, and to prove that even during a global pandemic, we can make the impossible possible.